me that maybe not all, but a significant percentage of scientific visualizations are preserving or in fact using the actual geometry, right? The geometry of the world. Right? So to that extent, there is some kind of physical process, a physical system, you know, rather, okay, you know, there's a geometric structure of molecules or geometric structure of cerebral cortex, right? And what you're doing is you're, okay, but we don't have photograph for this, right? So we have to visualize it. But I wonder if, so what you're saying is that, you know, maybe the difference is that in fact, in information visualization, you choose an arbitrary kind of geometric and topographic system because the data is not inherently visual. Whereas scientific visualization, the data actually does have geometric or topographic properties. But do you think it would apply to all scientific visualizations or just to a subset? It definitely makes sense to me with this distinction. Well, this is, you know, somebody has to go, right? And maybe it's not so important, but I think it is interesting to, I think it's important to make these distinctions. You guys want to?
Here it's time for our lunch.
So we have time.
What's the time? What time is it? No, but it's
1.
But it's already 1? You're kidding me.
5 to 1.
Wow.
5 to 1.
Really?
Wow. No, 5 minutes.
Okay, well, we still have 7 minutes. Okay. Wow, this is really, oh my God. Okay, that's good. This is going slow. Okay, anyway. So, well, let me just maybe cover another chapter really quickly. So then there is a third development, and we have to somehow put information. I'm not sure like where we put information design here. Maybe 89. Which is recently new, which is called visual analytics. So it's not as well known. And the difference is that, let's say, with scientific visualization, because the development of scientific visualization in some ways also corresponds to the development of 3D computer graphics, lots of emphasis was on techniques. So how can we do like volume rendering, you know? What color should we use? So it's basically, okay, we're just happy to be able to make these images on our scientific workstations and, you know, show in some conference. And today, let's say the techniques for visualizing information in 3D, in 2D, and also making these visualizations interactive, relatively well developed. So there's this new field called visual analytics, and the difference is that the emphasis is more on how people actually use visualization environments, and let's say the cognitive factors, so the connection to the cognitive science. So I think to a certain extent, it's kind of the same field, it's the same area, it's the same research, but the emphasis is more on, let's say less on how to make these visualizations, to how actually people use it, what kind of interfaces we should provide, and so on and so forth. So there's this very useful resource called InfoVis Wiki, and it's a pretty good source of definitions for these concepts. So if we go look at visual analytics here, what's good about it, we're going to provide not one definitions, but we're going to provide a few. And again, like as it's always the case of two fields, some of the definitions are going to be contradictory and very much overlapping. So this says visual analytics is a science of analytical reasoning facilitated by interactive visual interfaces. So as you can see, there is more emphasis on how people use it, right? What kind of reasoning, what kind of cognition. I'm a little bit afraid to use this term in this context, because there are people who can immediately like, right, kind of beat me up. But maybe I can even use the word epistemology. Right? So how do you reason using interactive visual interfaces? So the reason I'm bringing this up is that so far this concept exists in the scientific domain. So what we're kind of trying to do is to say, well, this concept can also apply to sort of use of cultural and social data, right? So maybe you can say that, you know, if visual analytics applies to, potentially it can be general, but the way it's, of course, developed so far is in science and also, you know, in the sort of government agency. agencies and surveillance and so on and so forth, is the use of reasoning supported by interactive visual interfaces, in particular supported by the interactive visualization. Then maybe we can talk about cultural analytics, right? Maybe cultural analytics versus cultural analysis. So cultural analysis would be what we know how to do well for the 20th century, which is to look at cultural objects and think about them and read other books and extract some theories and tools and develop our own and write about them. But what kind of new type of cultural analysis can you do if you have the same tools used by some scientists? So that's why we define this concept of cultural analytics. So here are some other definitions where people, I think, try to separate this. So visual analytics is more than just visualizations. It can be seen as an integrative approach combining visualizations, human factors, data analysis, geospatial analytics, and particular role of human factors. That's another definition, which is kind of interesting. And of course, you can see how the definition, in fact, is almost very much parallels the definition of data mining, right? But data mining doesn't really tell you how do you do it in practice. The idea is that, right, along with statistical tools and some other software tools, you want to actually be able to display the data visually and manipulate it and find patterns. And maybe these examples, right, which I showed you in the beginning, give you some very preliminary idea of how this kind of cultural analytics would work in relation to particular cultural data sets. But I like this kind of quote where it says, visual analytics is a formation of abstract visual metaphors in combinations with human information discourses with some formal interactions. And here we have the definition, which I think is taken from the definition of data mining, that enables detection of expected and discovery of unexpected within massive dynamically changing information spaces. And one of the things which we also kind of question after a break is that this idea that the reason we want to visualize the data to discover patterns, right? So you want to get something very pragmatic, something functional from these visualizations, it's another idea which we need to question. Because when I started looking at, let's say, slow development of work, of artistic work in information visualization, which we also talk about, and I know you guys have lots of things to say about it, you can see already, and we also started developing kind of our own techniques, of course, we realized right away that in a cultural context, the purpose of visualization of cultural patterns, the discovery of patterns, the discovery of new information, knowledge, is just one particular purpose. Right? Because what you're also doing is you can think of visualizations as a new kind of artworks, but just as postmodern artworks, right, or media art, which creates new art objects out of existing media, you can think of these visualizations also a new type of artworks, which are driven, let's say, by the data extracted from previous culture. And of course, you know, we also act in a kind of estrangement, right? Estrangement tools, where we can take a very familiar kind of cultural object and defamiliarize it to us and perhaps allow us to see even not only the new cultural objects in YouTube videos or, let's say, other things, but also even maybe paintings by Makarovka or other very canonical objects anyways. So this is just examples of a couple of possible functions of, let's say, cultural visualizations, but I think when I try to make a list, I think you can easily come up with 6 or 7 different functions. So to that extent, you can say that the use of visualizations of cultural information, cultural processes, and cultural artifacts for us, right, is not something simply which is functional. It's not only some kind of diagnostic, right, or epistemological tool to discover or generate or produce new knowledge about culture, but these visualizations themselves, right, enter the culture and become new type of cultural objects. All right, I think I'm 2 minutes past, so I maybe have to speed up a little bit, but maybe not. So I guess Okay, so I'll see you hopefully guys after lunch at 4 o'clock, right? Thanks a lot.